Hello everyone, today I will show you how to easily define a treatment based on covariate values in Simulx. In the definition tab, I define the model with three covariates: age, weight and genotype. Age and weight are continuous covariates and genotype is categorical. My model includes an effect of weight on the volumes V and V2 and on the clearances CL and Q. It also includes an effect of age on CL and an effect of genotype on the dissociation constant KD. The structural model below links these input parameters to the output ligand concentration and total receptor occupancy. In the covariates tab, I define the covariate distribution. The weight and age are log normally distributed in the population with a typical value of 70 kg and 40 years old, and the associated normalized quotients have a standard deviation of 0.3. For the genotype, 80% of the population will be heterozygous and 20% homozygous. In the treatment tab, I define the regular treatment with a flat dose of 1 micromole per day. I can check in the exploration tab how the outputs respond to this treatment for a typical individual who has, for example, all its parameter values equal to 1. I mark this individual as the current reference. Imagine now an individual who has twice the same volume, clearance, Q and V2. Now, if I adjust the treatment by giving twice the dose amount, you see that I obtain again the same output as before. As weight has an effect on these four parameters in our model, we guess that a dose amount proportional to the weight will enable to reduce the variability in the output. To define a treatment based on a covariate, I can easily duplicate the current treatment, check the box Scale amount by a covariate, and I select weight. The value in amount is now an amount per kilogram, which gives the real amount when multiplied by weight. To choose a coefficient leading to a total dose similar to the previous treatment, I will use 1 micromole divided by 70 kg, which is the typical weight value, which gives 14 nanomole per kilogram. It is also possible to define an intercept, which is a dose amount that is added to the scale amount. I click on View to see the defined treatment, and I can see the scaling formula. In a simulation, Simulx will sample covariate values based on the specified covariate distribution and parameter values based on the population parameters and on the covariate values, and it will simulate the response of the model to the treatment. I create two groups. The first one will receive the flat dose and the second one will receive the treatment scaled by weight. To compare groups by focusing only on the difference in the treatment, I choose to have same individuals among groups. In the plots, you can see that outputs have the same typical dynamic behavior for the two treatments, but the variability in the output is much lower in the case of a scaled treatment. In the Results tab, I can check the list of parameters sampled by Simulx to generate these results. The different dose amounts administered to each of the individuals are stored in the result folder in a table located in the simulation folder called doses.txt. I could also decide to scale the treatment by age, since age has a negative effect on the clearance. To give lower doses to older patients, I define a decreasing linear relationship using a negative amount and a positive intercept. To check the scaling formula, I click on View. For a typical 40-year-old, this treatment gives 1400 minus 10 times 40, which is equal to 1000 nanomole. This is what I want. I will now simulate this new treatment. I look at the plots again, and you see that the variability also decreased a little. To scale the amount by age and weight, or to have another more complex personalized dosing, I will need to define treatment and covariates as external tables with the list of treatments, one per individual. Finally, it is also possible to use categorical covariates in the scaling. In my example, you see that the heterozygous genotype leads to a higher KD. And in the exploration tab, I see that if I increase KD, the target occupancy increases. To compensate for this effect, I could give a lower dose to heterozygous genotypes. I duplicate again the treatment. I scale the amount by genotype. I give a lower factor for the heterozygous category. The formula shows that the heterozygous category will receive 800 nanomole instead of 1000 for the homozygous. Note that the Simulx project is based on one of the demo projects that you can load from the main menu. This one is located in Definition, Treatments, and it is the Treatment Weight and Genotype-based demo project. Browsing yourself through all these projects is a great way to explore Simulx. See you next week!